Your first videos are going to suck. But what if I told you that's the exact reason why you need to be making bad videos? I've been making videos for 15 years and I've made my fair share of bad videos. What I've learned is that making bad videos is actually the secret to growing as a content creator and on YouTube. Yeah, I know it sounds kind of crazy to be making bad videos, but by the end of this one, I'm gonna share with you why it's so important to be making bad videos. And this video is part of a 7-day series that I'm putting on my YouTube channel. So if you're following along or if you're watching this video on the day that I released it, make sure you come back tomorrow and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss a single video of this series. Number one is that learning to make bad videos actually helps you to get better at creating good videos. When you think about a rite of passage, someone or something has to go from point A to point B. They have to go through this path, this journey. It's required in order for them to go from one place to another. I see that as true when it comes to going from making bad videos to making good videos. No one can skip this process. For anyone who does try to skip this process, they usually end up not creating any videos because it's simply just not possible. People who have millions and millions of subscribers and a big audience and their videos look amazing, when they first started, chances are their videos look nothing like what they are today. So you have to understand that improving from bad to good videos is just a part of the process. It's a part of the journey in this content creation game that is unavoidable. You might as well accept the fact that you're going to start somewhere, and when you start, more than likely your videos are not going to be that great. I love the quote by Zig Ziglar. It says, "You don't have to be great to start, but you have to start in order to be great." And I would like to add to that, and when you do start, you probably won't be that good. And one of the things that I have learned in this process is that there's certain things that I can learn from reading information, watching videos, but then there's other things that you have to learn by doing. Creating videos and learning how to make good videos falls into the category of learn by doing. Sure, you can pick up some good information. You're watching this video, which I appreciate, and hopefully this inspires you and informs you. But in order for you to actually grow when it comes to going from making bad videos to good videos, you actually have to do. You have to learn by doing. And there's certain things that you're simply just not gonna learn from any video, any course, any material, but it's the experience of you actually taking action that you're gonna find all of these different ways to improve your videos. And just by doing, you're going to improve the different skills that comes with creating videos. And if you only take away one thing from this video, it's to just get started. So here are some of the things that happens when you start to create bad videos. The first thing is that you start to build a level of confidence that is needed in order to start to make good videos. When you first start getting in front of the camera, it's obviously going to feel awkward to most people. But as you spend more and more time in front of the camera, you start to build up a level of comfortability. You start to find your voice, you start to find your cadence, and usually you start to like it a lot more. And this is one of the best feelings in the world, because when you can confidently speak on camera, oh man, it's like your whole world opens up. And the only way that you really get there is by taking the time to speak to the camera, create videos, go through the entire process of scripting, recording, editing, and publishing these sets of videos. Then you will actually start to build up a level of confidence to know that, one, you can create videos, but then, two, your videos are getting better. The second thing that happens is you start to build your unique style. Now, every YouTube channel and every creator is slightly different, which is a great thing. And you have to find whatever your unique style, flavor, swag is on the different platform. And even though there might be several other creators who are creating content around the same general topic, no one's going to do it quite like you. No one's gonna deliver it like you. No one has your unique perspective or experience. And so by creating these bad videos, what you start to discover is what your unique style is. When you're able to discover that, then you can actually start incorporating more of that into your content, because that's what's gonna make you you. And when you show up as you, then that's when the viewer is going to start to connect and relate to you. You start to build that trust with them, and then that's when they really want to follow your content, engage with you, and maybe even do business with you if you have some type of offering on the backside of your content. And this takes time to figure out, because you're trying to find yourself and get kind of into your own skin. You want to be in your own skin when you're creating content, and the only way that you can get there is by creating these bad videos. The third thing that's going to happen when you start making bad videos is that you're going to get feedback from your audience. The people who you're looking to target, the people that you're making the content for, will respond. They will leave comments in the comment section about what type of content they want to see. They might even suggest certain video ideas. And if your content is providing good value, they will also let you know. This is really good feedback, because in this beginning stage, you're looking to discover what the audience truly wants and how you can provide it and where those two things intersect. So by listening to the feedback, that helps you to make better videos. This is valuable because if you want to sustain as a content creator and you want your audience to grow, you have to be willing to listen to that feedback and adjust your content so that when you do put it out there, there are people wanting to consume it. And the more that you do this, the better ideas that you will have from your audience. And again, if you have a business on the backside of this, your audience will end up telling you what products and services they want from you. And then all you have to do is provide that. In a similar fashion, content and video ideas can work the same way. And when you get started, here are the things that you should focus on. The first is consistency over perfection. In the beginning, it's more important that you create content regularly. It's not about making the videos perfect. It's not about them having the perfect script or the perfect editing or you speaking on camera without any mistakes. The point is to be consistent and spend a lot of time just in the practice of creating videos. When you do this, you will see that you will learn by doing. You will learn through all of the different tasks that there are when it comes to creating content. What will keep you from learning is if you're worried about making each video perfect. So don't focus on that. Focus on being consistent. Set up a time in your schedule that allows you to record content consistently. That's actually what's going to be most important when it comes to this learning process. The second thing to focus on is authenticity and storytelling. I love this one, and this is so important, especially in your entire journey as a content creator, not just in the beginning. But especially in the beginning, because we're focused on just showing up regularly, what you can do is focus on being you, finding your voice, finding how you can present yourself in front of the camera and in your videos and be you. It's going to take some time for you to do this. You might have a certain voice or a certain way of presenting yourself on camera that isn't really authentic to you. That's why this is one of the things that you should focus on. And one of the best ways that you can find your voice and be authentic in your content is to focus on storytelling. Storytelling allows you to just share what your experience is, and no one else has that experience. No one else has that perspective. And so if you're focused on telling stories through your content, even if it's educational content, that allows you to focus more on being your true self. And when you're your true self, people will start to resonate with you. The third thing to focus on is audio quality over video quality. When it comes to videos, audio is 50% of the viewing experience. And people are more forgiving for poor video quality than they are for poor audio quality. And if this video had the perfect video quality, best camera, best image, but really bad audio, you probably would click off of this video. So it's important to have good audio. And if you're going to make any type of investments in any type of gear, especially at the beginning, it should be in audio. And so for instance, I have the DJI Mic 2 and I use this pretty much in all of my videos, especially ones where I'm out and about. This mic allows me to get really good audio quality without being so close to the camera. Because it's wireless, I can be hundreds of feet away from the camera and still get good audio quality. A wireless microphone like this allows you to be really close to the camera and be really far away and still get good audio quality. But that leads me to the fourth thing, which is to don't focus on gear in the beginning. You'll have plenty of time to upgrade your setup, your camera, microphones, all of that stuff. But in the beginning, just use what you have. Use your smartphone, use a computer webcam, whatever you have at your disposal. It is possible to be successful at content creation and on YouTube just with the tools that you already have. So really, it's not about having all of the best equipment and gear. It's about using the right tools, which are often the ones that we already have at our disposal. Okay, here are the things not to focus on when creating bad videos. The first is cinematic shots or perfect lighting. When you see other creators on the platform, you might see their setups and think, wow, their stuff is dialed in, it looks good, it's crispy. But that usually has taken some time to develop. And in the beginning, it's very likely that your lighting and your studio setup is not gonna look that great. And it's not necessarily what we're trying to focus on in the beginning. So you can always improve that over time. Unless that is your focus as a filmmaker or a visual storyteller, I wouldn't necessarily focus on that. What's more important, as we talked about earlier, was just having face time on the camera and then developing your storytelling ability and just being truly you. And to be honest, you can have all of the equipment, have the best setup, have all the cinematic shots, but if you can't tell a story, if you're not authentically you, and if the content that you're providing is not valuable, then people will simply not be able to resonate. Your stuff will look cool, but it's building that deeper relationship with the viewer that's gonna allow you to grow and build an audience over time. That's truly what we're after. The next thing is to not focus so much on metrics and analytics in the beginning. Now, eventually, yes, it's important to understand the metrics when it comes to your videos, but when you're starting out, don't get into the trap of going through your video analytics, because you will find that when you publish a video, only 4 people will watch it. And it's probably your mom or your dad or one of your kids who've watched it 4 times. And that's okay, that's all right. And because you're starting out, usually YouTube doesn't even have enough data to actually make looking at the analytics worth it. You might only have 1 or 2 or 3 or less than 50 videos on your channel. And so there's not enough of a sample size for you to be able to look and see exactly what's going on. But there is a caveat here. I do recommend understanding what the YouTube analytics and metrics mean. And at some point in the future, I'll have a video right up here where you can check out what the metrics mean, what to look for, and how to use that to grow and build your channel. But in the beginning, just focus on getting out videos. I'll also mention you should not focus on going viral. If you want to be in this game a long time, it is important to find out what trends are working, what type of content is growing on the different platforms. But in the beginning, again, you should just focus on bettering and improving yourself through the process of creating bad videos. What will be consistent and what will sustain over time is putting out valuable content that your audience loves and consumes, and making that exchange all day long. You may never have a video that quote unquote goes viral. And there are plenty of creators out there who have never had a viral video who are doing really well as a content creator. So don't necessarily think that that's your one-way ticket to being this influencer or creator, or if that's the only way to be successful as a content creator or YouTuber, because it's not. There's plenty of people who have less than, say, 1,000 views on each one of their videos who are doing really well, who have a 6 or 7-figure business on the backside of their YouTube channel. Sure, going viral can be fun, it's exciting, you get a lot of exposure and reach, but at the end of the day, you have to measure that on how sustainable it really is. And most people may never even have a video that goes viral. The way I would describe trying to go viral is like trying to shoot a half-court shot with one arm and blindfolded. Whereas the approach that I've taken, and which I think is more sustainable, is driving to the basket and making simple layups. These layups will add up over time, and if you can consistently do it, then you will be successful and be able to sustain for a longer period of time. And the last piece of this process is to just get started. And one of the best ways that you can do that is by taking a 7-day talk to camera challenge. I actually did this myself and I improved more in the 7 days than I have probably in the last year and a half. Check out the video right here on the screen where I share exactly how I did this and how you can do it too. Thanks so much for watching this video. I will see you in the next one.